And now, a look at how the coronavirus pandemic has forced people in a way to change how they interact with each other and seek out new ways to connect and to celebrate. Lisa Desjardins has the story.
When Berkeley Souza turned 12 last month, a birthday party was out of the question. Her state, California, was under a shelter-in-place order.
She's a kid. She doesn't understand. There was a lot of, you know, I hate everything, and why did it have to be in March, and crying, and she was just really bumming. So we wanted to surprise her with something.
So instead of a party, her mom, Holly, organized a birthday parade. One car after another, filled with friends and family, drove by her Bakersfield home. One even had a special delivery for her, a cake.
Thank you, Chelsea.
Just to wake up and then come out front and see all the people come by was really cool, a really cool experience, and made me feel a lot better about my birthday.
Across the country, parades have also become tools for teachers trying to stay in touch with students while school is closed. They ride in a caravan and wave to families lining the streets. Families are finding new ways to connect with each other as well. Grandfather Dave Schneiders of Indianapolis visited his one-year-old grandson, David Drew, through a living room window. Nursing homes are off limits for most outsiders, so in Middletown, Ohio, Charlie Adams used a bucket truck to visit his 80-year-old mother on the third floor.
Make sure you wash your hands.
Yes.
People are reinventing partying, too. DJ D-Nice has been spinning records live for people to dance at home. Just him, great music, and the occasional hat change. Sometimes 9 hours straight. One virtual party of his drew over 100,000 people watching, including celebrities.
Michelle Obama's in here. Oh my gosh, let's go. We are partying right now.
On a smaller scale, people are taking their talents to their front porches. Here's a recent classical violin performance for passersby in a Washington, D.C. neighborhood. In Saratoga Springs, Utah, Heather Downey taught a Zumba class for her neighbors from her backyard.
There's something about that endorphin rush that you get when you dance, and I think everybody can relate to that. Even if you feel like you can't dance, there's just something about moving that sends those happy endorphins out. And so it's been such a blessing to be able to move again.
When we'll all be able to move around freely again remains an open question. But for newly turned 12-year-old Berkeley Souza, she has already learned a powerful lesson.
Even though there's a lot of things going on right now in the world, you can still do something to make it better. Not everything can be negative about everything that's going on, and to just stay positive during this.
For the PBS NewsHour in Washington, I'm Lisa Desjardins.
And happy birthday to you, Berkeley. And boy, do we now have ideas for how to spend the day. Thank you all. Thank you, Lisa.